And here we go. Moving on to question number 93. In the figure below, the measure of angle A equals the measure of angle F, and those are marked congruent already. Line segment AB equals line segment DF. Those are marked congruent. Angle ACB and DCF are vertical angles. Yeah, we can see they're across from each other, and we know that all vertical angles are congruent. Next piece of information says if the measure of angle B equals the measure of angle F plus 35 degrees. So we need to find out what's the measure of angle F. We'll call that X. We'll call that X. Angle B is X plus 35. And the measure of angle ACB is 45. So in there, that's 45 degrees. Then what is the measure of angle D? Measure of angle D is going to be the same as B, because that's the third angle in the triangle, and the other two angles are the same. So X plus 35. What is a measure of angle D? So we need to find out what is X plus 35. That's the question. What is the measure of angle D? Okay, I'm gonna switch my color. Purple and gold, here we go. My three angles inside of my triangle have to add up to how much? So we need angle C, D, and F. So C, if this is 45, this is 45. D, we put that as X plus 35 plus angle F. We said we're just going to call it X. Those three angles have to add up to how much? Even though we got some variables in there, they still have to add up to 180 degrees. And since we know that these angles are related to each other, we can find out the measure of all three angles. Step one, over here, we need to, you know it, combine like terms. So my 45 and my 35, those can be added together. If you guys notice, I'm always being such a little dork over here and writing out my simple addition and subtraction and multiplication because the CLT exam, you're not allowed to use a calculator at all, right? So 5 plus 5 is 10, and 4 plus 3, 7 plus 1 more makes 8. So those add up to 80. And then I've got two X's left, right? An X and an X. So plus 2x has to equal 180. And now we just solve for x now that it's simplified on that left side. So to get rid of the 80, it's positive. Subtract it out. And we got 2x equals 100. Get the x by itself. Yep, divide both sides by 2 to give us x equals 50. And our answer is not 50 though, right? The question was, what's the measure of angle D? Angle D is x plus 35, so we know x is 50. So I can wipe out the x and plug in the 50, and our answer is 50 plus 35. which is going to be answer choice B, 85 degrees. And, okay, that's it for number 93. And now we're going to move forward to question number 94. Says, circle C has its center at the origin. So, okay, so we got a circle in a coordinate plane. Point C is a center. And there's some circle. Okay. Point A, whose coordinates are square root of 2 over 2, square root of 2 over 2, lies on circle C. So that's going to be quadrant 1. And we'll just call that right here. That's point A. Lies on circle C. Point B, whose coordinates are square root of 2 over 0. Is the third vertex in triangle ABC. Where AC equals 1. That's 1. What is the measure of angle C? Well, I can see right here, because this is straight up and down, we do have a 90 degree angle. So a 90 degree angle. So I'm going to rewrite my triangle a little bit bigger off to the side here. Mark my 90 degree angle. Mark my hypotenuse as 1. And now what is the measure of angle C? That's the question. Right here, angle C. To figure this out, okay, we got 1, and we know also that from C to B, right, is square root of 2 over 2. And we also know, that our height on this side is also square root of 2 over 2. And whoopsie poopsie, looks like Mrs. Cameron did not draw her triangle to scale, because this leg and this leg of our triangle are the same. So if I know I got my 90 degree angle here, and this side and this side's the same, that means these two angles are the same. So my three angles got to add up to 180. And if this one's 90, these two got to add up to 90. Half of 90 is going to give me 45 degrees. Yay. Got it. And then, okay, we can look at number 95. An astronomer is measuring the orbits of asteroids OSIRIS and Bennu around a planet. The ratio of the length of the orbit of asteroid OSIRIS to the length of the orbit of asteroid Bennu is 13:4. The ratio of the length of the orbit of OSIRIS to Bennu is 13:4. The orbit of asteroid OSIRIS is 247 days. If the orbit of a third asteroid Sobek is 75% less than the orbit of Bennu, then how many days long is the orbit of Sobek in days? Okay, so we got OSIRIS, Bennu. And then we've got Sobek. And I'm keeping them in the order that I read them in the word problem. And our ratio of the length of the orbit of OSIRIS to Bennu is 13:4. And I know that the orbit of the asteroid OSIRIS is 247 days. So in order for me to find out anything about Sobek, we got to find out how long is the orbit in days of Bennu. So to do that, I'm going to set up a proportion and say, okay, so this ratio, 13 to 4, is going to equal this ratio, 247 to x, our unknown. And to solve a proportion, what do? We're gonna cross multiply. So we're gonna multiply x times 13, I just get 13x equals 247 times 4, and 4 times 7, that's 28. 4 times 4 is 16 plus 2, 8. 4 times 2 is 8 plus 1, 9, so that's 988. And then I need to get my x by itself to find out how much is x, how many days. So I need to divide that by 13. And I'll take some of this space back here to do some long division. This looks like a perfect little beginning of the year, fifth grade long division question from when I used to teach fifth grade. 988 divided by 13, a number times 13. I'm going to make my T chart because I don't have my 13th times tables memorized. Maybe you do. That was never my thing to memorize that. 13 times 1, 13 times 2, 26 times 3, 39 times 4. Actually, I'm going to keep going for 5, 6. If I just double 39, 40 plus 40 is 80 minus 2, 78. Save a little time. Add another 13. Going to be at 91. So 13 goes into 98 7 times. Minus 91, right? I'm lining up nice and neat, just like a good little fifth grader. And now we subtract. 8 minus 1 is 7. Bring down the 8. And I just love my T-chart because look, there it is. I know that 78 divided by 13 is 6. So Bennu's orbit is 76 days. And now I am done with all of this. So I'll clean up my workspace again. Ooh, need to finish up. Okay. And now the last piece of information, we need to find out how many days long is the orbit of Sobek. And it's 75% less than the orbit of Bennu. So I'm just going to take this orbit, 76, and multiply it times 0.25. And 6 times 5 is 30. 6 times 2 is 12 plus 3 is 15. Placeholder 0, 7 times 5, 35, 7 times 2, 14, plus 3, 17, add them up, 7, 8, 9, 19, two numbers behind the decimal, two numbers behind the decimal, 19 days, and bum, bada, bum, found the answer and kept our video under 15 minutes. All right, guys, I will catch you on the next one.